Welcome to the Louisiana Motor Speedway here in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. This is a brand new rectangular short track here in just outside of Baton Rouge. And this track has been very interesting for some of the drivers, at least in the qualifying race, the 130-lap qualifying race, 60-mile qualifying race, in which we saw the transition between the apron and the banking of the corners isn't exactly the greatest, and a lot of drivers tend to be quite aggressive around this track, so you got to be very, very careful with making moves around this track. And this track isn't the easiest to pass on either. It takes a lot of guts to actually make a move on this track. Big qualifying news update is that Nathan McCain, the Road Atlanta winner, and is in top five in points, didn't make the race either, and points leader Scott Roush was struggling for a little while in the qualifier, and eventually did make it into the race. After, or at least in the pre-race for qualifying for Talladega, we will show you the points results, simply because I think it's a little early to be really concerned about them right now, and they're a little bit chaotic since not all drivers have points yet. The last main thing about qualifying is Jeffrey Fingai shockingly made the race again, along with two Menervinis of Juan Pablo Corona and Damir Bezianov. Anyway, let's get to the race. It's an all-Hart front row here at Louisiana Motor Speedway, and away we go. Noah Hart leads the field down to the green here. Jacob Hart on his outside, and away we go into two Kona sex in second and third. Looks like Noah and Jacob Hart are having a pretty close battle here. We're expecting this track to have a lot of early race incidents like we do at typically most short tracks. Jacob Hart takes a big lead. They're coming out there, and Jacob Hart's gonna lead the first lap. But right now, William Brock might have a, Brock is out. Brock has a engine grenade. He is out of the race. A little further back through the order, we're seeing Damir Bezianov and the Red Bulls, the Menervinis back here. This is the first time Menervinis made the race, leaving Richard Baxter Motorsports, I think the only team not to make a race so far this season. It's been kind of a surprise that we've seen this many cars make a race this season. But this could be a big race for people in their points hauls because of need to be within the top 35 after leaving Talladega. And right now, we're kind of concerned that some of these cars aren't going to. Look at Jeffrey Fingai, who has been really quick around here in the very slow Team Flame car. He is in 14th position around this track in a Team Flame car. And on lap 5 of 260, that is impressive. Meanwhile, Vincent Allen now is looking underneath Fingai for the position here. And this is very difficult, like I said, to make a move on this track. As you can see, Vincent Allen had to back way out of the throttle because of, that's a terrible camera angle. Because of Jeffrey Fingai holding the middle line. This track is very middle line biased, to say the least, here. Scott Roush is our points leader entering this race. He's running P20 right now, and I think he's going to want a lot more out of this to retain his point lead. Can gain 185 points in a race, and that is going to be very, very difficult for Roush to keep up his point lead, especially with cars like Charles Samper way up the order. Fifth position, you got Nick Pericles, who's up the grid, in sixth position, the Daytona winner. Looks like a slow job there by Charles Samper, and that's going to have Pericles get underneath him here, that's because we're getting into lap traffic already. That is Bezianov that Jacob Hart has caught now, and that's going to give Noah Hart the lead. And Noah Hart's trying to get by there. Ooh, that's an aggressive move by Rahal on the inside of Jacob Hart. You don't want to do that too often, and they make the move stick. As there's, the 73 is coming on the outside now of Rahal. This is where things are going to get quite interesting here. Look at Noah Hart diving under there, trying to get underneath the 78 car. Here is Madeline Myatt. She's doing a great job here in the 11 car. That car itself rolled over in the qualifying race, and they fixed it and got it going again. Actually, the main event has been a lot cleaner in the qualifying race so far. I think by lap 15, we've already had two cautions by now in the qualifier. So, looks like we got one of the Menervinis coming down pit road, as you're going to see. This whole pack is all very conglomerated here as Madeline Myatt's going underneath the 8 cars. Like I said, the inside line isn't exactly the best here. Sorry, the camera angles around this track aren't exactly the greatest either. Kind of a very awkward track to kind of get cameras set up for. Once getting through some of the lap traffic, Noah Hart has opened up a rather large lead over Jacob Hart in second position. Tyler Thaber is running third, along with Roman Rahal, Charles Samford, Nick Pericles, Ryan Griffin up to seventh, trying to chase down his teammate. They've had a couple of issues with each other as Jessica Shelton's already, I think, pitted and had a tire go down, so Shelton is running 38th position. Damir Bezianov is coming out of the pits now in a very interesting thing here. You got to be real careful coming out of the pits on this track, but right now Bezianov does make it kind of work there. Noah Hart has hit some more heavy lap traffic here, and this is where Jacob Hart really closes in here. Like I said, this track is very difficult to make moves on, as he's got to get by the lap car of Nikula, who just barely made the made this race through the qualifier. Zachary Fitzwater, who was absolutely fantastic in the qualifying race, not doing well in the main event here. Oh, whoa, Noah Hart got really sideways here, and that's going to give Jacob Hart the outside line. Contact between the two. I'm sure that wasn't intentional there by Jacob Hart. And it looks like Jacob Hart's going to take the lead maybe here on Noah Hart. Yes, he does. Jacob Hart to the lead as Noah Hart falls back. That's going to put Thaber and Rahal right to Noah's rear bumper. Meanwhile, Damir Bezianov does not look very strong right now. Maybe that car's down a cylinder or something. Corona looked a lot quicker than him. As there goes Mathias Paulsen and Zachary Fitzwater trying to get by on the inside now as Jacob Hart's trying to deal with R2 Nikula in the 25 car. This is one of those kinds of things where you got to be really careful. Here comes Tyler Thaber to the inside of Noah Hart in the Kona Seg. That's going to be a pretty big move there for Thaber if he can make that one stick. And I believe he might actually. And yes, he... No, I'm not sure. It's just a very, very difficult situation for some of these drivers to get through some of this lap traffic. I think this is the another race in a row that Jake Baskinger's had some kind of mechanical problem from the main event, and I don't think Baskinger at this rate is going to make it. He might be stuck in the qualifiers in the future because, they're going to try and fix the car, even though it was on fire. Noah Hart now has fallen all the way back to fourth on this run because of the rather difficult kind of construction of this track. Oh, somebody's grenading up in front of him. That's Thaber's Kona Seg. So Thaber's Kona Seg has just grenaded, and that's going to get Rahal and a bunch of cars by Hart there. But Tyler Thaber from second position is going to fall out of the race, and he's not even going to make it to pit road, so that actually might bring out the first yellow of the race. I'm not sure. We saw an incident yesterday where a car grenading did, but Thaber's far enough off the track that they're going to keep it green. So while Noah Hart seems to have fallen back to fourth position again, actually got by Pericles on the outside, he was falling back to fifth, but Noah Hart is still back in fourth position after being held up there. As Charles Sampras up to second, got by Rahal there. As, ooh, more shenanigans in front as Jacob Hart continues to lead this race through some very heavy lap traffic as, whoa, he gets by Fitzwater pretty easily there. As Noah Hart's trying underneath Rahal for third, that's gotta be a very aggressive move there. Look at Kyle Collins up to sixth. We didn't see Collins there before. As, oh yeah, Noah Hart's battling for fifth. I'm sorry about that. Fourth or fifth. Oh, this is very kind of a close pack racing here as Jacob Hart's actually gotten away from that pack. More problems for Jessica Shelton as she would bring it down pit road. And that would, I think, have another tire issue with that car. Now it's Alex Allen's turn to come down pit road with a tire problem. As you can see, this pit lane is very, very narrow, and we saw issues with that as this in the qualifying race. Chris Washer right now is just outside of the top 10. That's a very impressive showing by Washer. We didn't really expect the Bruce Matthews car up that high up the grid, but a great run there. Madeline Maya doing a good job. Moshe Gurian up there. Jeffrey Fingai still in 14th. What a run by that team, by that car. Team Flames, only car that's ever made a race, is doing very, very well here. As Dodd, Ethan Moore, the qualifier winner. Vander Pesch, Scott Roush is working his way up the order, slowly but carefully. Ben Atkins and Sean Angel. Ben Atkins needs a couple of good runs here as well. He's right now outside of the top 35 in points. Aiden Shepherd made his first race of the year so far, and now he has grenaded the motor, and he's going to fall, I believe, out of the race right there. So tough break for Aiden Shepherd. I'm sure he didn't want to have that happen to him. This was immediately followed by Christian Vanderpesch grenading his car, and that's going to put Vanderpesch out of the race as well. So tough break for the Red Bull driver. Jacob Hart would come up here on Juan Pablo Corona to lap him, and that would actually put Corona into the wall, and this is going to be the first yellow of the race as Noah Hart slides into him. Nick Pericles goes around, and Ryan Griffin hooks Pericles there, and Washer would hit the wall along with Alex Allen trying to avoid him, but luckily it was a pretty small wreck, but that's going to be the first caution of the race here on lap 42. On board with pole sitter Noah Hart, this is going to be a very, you're going to see this wreck happen in front of him here, and he just can't do a whole lot there to miss that wreck. This track isn't very wide. Now we're on board Nick Pericles, the Daytona winner and reigning champion, and you're just gonna see, well, Pericles couldn't do much there either. Now there was some shenanigans on pit road here. I'm not exactly sure what this was, as the 18 couldn't get into his pit stall, or the 19 rather, of DeMax couldn't get into his pit stall because of just some way that his location was, or his car would break down or something, and that would be a big problem for him here. As once, then that would actually stop the 34 there. That got his car going, and then the 24 car would kind of flip him. Kind of a weird incident there on pit road. So Jacob Hart leads on the restart over Charles Sanford and Kyle Collins. Green flag is out. We saw that these restarts were a big problem in the qualifying race, so we're hoping that those incidents don't take place this time around. And we're seeing, luckily, so far they're not. But now, Sanford's going to have to make a good run here on Jacob Hart. There was some problems on the restart for Eddie Shum Padkar. Padkar would need to bring it down pit road, but luckily he would rejoin the race here. I believe he only had a tire going down, so Padkar would rejoin. The big gainer on that pit stop cycle was Madeline Mai up to fourth position here in the BFM 11 car, the maroon and white car. Kind of surprising to see her that far up the order. I'm actually very shocked about that. Madeline Mai is hasn't won a race, obviously, because she is a rookie, and she is in the Rookie of the Year campaign. And Madeline Maya could end up getting this if she's lucky today. Oh, there's Lucien Ekdahl breaking down, and that's Ekdahl going to fall out of the race. Second caution of the race would happen as the field starts stacking up there. The 83 then would dump the 1, the 2 teammates would dump each other, and then the 32 would somehow go around as well. Yeah, because of that incident, Skyla Johnson wouldn't exactly pay attention there and get into Kyle Bishelia, and around they both would go. As you can see, this pit road isn't exactly the easiest to get in and out of. As you can see, there's a lot of close quarters pit contact here. Not an easy pit road, as pretty much the entire leaders decided that they were going to pit. As we go through a little bit more of the pit stop fun, it's a double pit lane, one of the only double pit lanes. I think the only double pit lane we go to. Oh, more contact there. That is Michaels and the 9 coming out of the pits of Bishelia. So yeah, it's really, you can only get one car through on pit road. It's not a double wide pit road. So on the restart, Jacob Hart would lead the field to the green here once again. That would be Chris Dodd in second. Third is Kyle Collins. Fourth is Madeline Myatt. And of course there is a car in the tail end of lead lap. That is Vincent Allen. Allen's got to be very careful here. But like I said, these restarts have been catastrophic here in the past. And if you're someone like some of these guys here, you got to be really careful here. As you're seeing Will Hoyt's a lap down, that's kind of surprising. As now Jacob Hart is pretty much in clean air, as Dodd is as well in second position. The 34 of Sean Angel and the 21 of Eddie Shum Padkar would be back on pit road. Not good for them. As Jacob Hart continues to lead this race over Chris Dodd and Kyle Collins. A lot of drivers I didn't expect up here so far, like Dodd, Collins, and Matty Myatt. I didn't expect Matty Myatt to be that strong here at Louisiana Motor Speedway. John Art would bring out the third caution here by getting on the apron and losing the rear end of the car, getting into Ryan Griffin, and that would be Henry Sanford also getting a bit of a piece, or not Henry Sanford, I think that's Paulson, rather, getting a bit of contact there. And a little further up the track, you've got a couple of cars wrecking here. Must be oil on the track or something, and that's going to bring out a couple more cars spinning. No damage, I don't think, from that, as Griffin's definitely got some front-end problems, and he is going to go out of this race. There's some radiator problems. Oh, three wide here. That's not a good idea. Four wide here briefly, and that will bring out the... They somehow made that work. Because of when that caution came out, only three cars are on the lead lap now because of the placement of when the yellow flew. That would be Jacob Hart, Kyle Collins, and Chris Dodd. Matty Myatt would have been on the lead lap. However, she pitted, and it ended up screwing up more things there. I think there's a little bit of a controversy about how these three are on the lead lap, but only three cars are on the lead lap here. I'm not sure how that happened, but Hart gets off to a good start here, and now I think a lot of these drivers, like Matty Mai and them, are going to be hoping for another quickie. Well, they're not going to get it. Are hoping for a quickie yellow one to get by some of these cars, but Nick Pericles seemed to bottle that one up there as Kyle Collins now is all over the back of the race leader of Jacob Hart, who has simply dominated this race. Han has been the fastest car as Dodd is trying to get by Ethan Moore, the lap car. And this race has taken kind of a surprising turn here. Ben Atkins would be trying some pretty aggressive moves here, and Joshua Michaels would just turn him right into the wall, and there's Mattias Paulsen and the 8 car sliding in there, and that's going to bring out the next caution of the race. Yes, this is Ben Atkins. He would fall out of the race from this. This isn't what Atkins needed, and Paulsen would just spin out trying to avoid, and the 8 car had nowhere to go. Due in part to the 47, the 3, and the 08 pitting, there is a ton of cars on the tail end of the lead lap now that are going to try and get back on the lead lap and hope for a quick yellow here, which right now hasn't exactly been that hard of a opportunity to get here as green flag comes out. All the cars pretty much on the outside line in front of Jacob Hart are on the tail end of the lead lap. And that's going to make things very interesting for these drivers to try and see what they can do. As there's Damir Bezianov, and that's not what Jacob Hart wants. Hart wants to start lapping some of these cars, and well, I don't know if that's going to be as much of an easy prospect as it sounds. Remember, Jacob Hart has dominated this race so far, but some people like Scott Roush, our point leader. Oh, there's Sanford coming in. Sanford was one of the cars trying to get back onto the lead lap. Or actually was. He was on the tail end of the lead lap, and that's going to hurt his shots there of doing that with a tire problem. Kyle Collins now is trying to set up the car in front of him. Oh, crash in front there. That's a big hit there for Ethan Moore. And Ethan Moore is out of this race. We're going to take a look and see what happened. So Madeline Myatt, I think, was coming out of the pits here, and Ethan Moore really wasn't paying attention there, and, well, Moore would go around, and, oh, man, that was a big hit by Roman Rahal there, and that's going to put another car that was trying to get back on the lead lap out of this race. So Jacob Hart continues to lead, this time over a couple of other cars here. He has a couple of cars in between himself and second placement. Jeffrey Fingai is on the tail end of the lead lap in seventh position in the Team Flame car. Fingai is doing an awesome job in the Team Flame car, just keeping that one in the showing. And that's easier said than done, to be honest with you. As Fingai gets a green there, Fingai took the field to the green. And now it's going to be very important for some of these lap cars, like the 11, the 4, to try and get something here out of the 47 car. And that's going to be pretty difficult to do. One driver that did benefit from that whole caution angle was Ryan Matthews. Matthews looking very strong in fourth position here. We didn't really expect this out of Matthews, to be honest with you, as nobody has really seen Matthews really this season so far. Matthews is doing quite well, and he hasn't actually been all that strong this weekend either. More problems for Madeline Myatt coming out of the pits. And, oh, we got another yellow here. That's not good. Madeline Myatt was back on pit road again, but we got to see what happened with the yellow. This one was due to a mechanical problem. Jessica Shelton would break down here, and there's not a whole lot she could do. And she would pull it kind of alongside there. And with cars coming, that's kind of a dangerous spot. The big person to benefit from the pit stop cycle this time was Kyle Bischelli, who leapfrogged up to second position with a quick pit stop here. And I think a clean pit road, because there was nobody that really pitted on the lead lap that's on his side of the pit road here, as Jacob Hart still leads this race. It's been a Jacob Hart stomp fest here. And we're going to have Hart take the field back to the green again here. Jacob Hart has led quite handily this race. Except now Jacob Hart's got a problem with this car, and he's going to have to bring it down pit road. And that is not good for Jacob Hart, because now he has a tire going down. However, Jacob Hart would get saved by the caution flag as Bazianov would go around. Madeline Myatt has nowhere to go. The 10 flips Bazianov on his side. Nick Pericles would get a piece. Dodd would get a piece. And the 12 would spin out as well. And the 11 was the big fallout there. Madeline Myatt would fall out of the race. I'm more with Maddie, as we're going to see this race just... We're going to see them 78 just loses control of the car. And around they go, and well, that kind of is just a big stack up there. So Kyle Collins leads this race over Jeffrey Finguy, Kyle Bischelia, Ryan Matthews, Scott Roush, and Jacob Hart, who got really lucky with that caution that he did not get a lap down. However, right as we're going green, you can see Jeffrey Finguy is going to grenade the 29 car. And I think that's going to be in a caution immediately there. Ah, what a tough break for the 29. Yes, and the 29 car from running second in Team Flames car would break down, and he has no power, and he's stuck in the middle of the track. And he does a great job, or everybody else does a great job not hitting him. Kyle Collins leads on the restart over Kyle Bischelia, Scott Roush, and Jacob Hart, four cars on the lead lap. It's a tough break for Jeffrey Finguy, because that was a huge race for him going there, and the Flame just gave up on him. As, ooh, lots of cars, I think, coming down pit road. There's a good deal of them here. Not too many cars left. Oh, Alex Allen's coming on pit road for 15th. A number of laps down. Actually, we got another car on pit road. That's Ryan Matthews. Been stuck on pit road, and we got a caution somewhere. I can hear the crashing in the background. Same kind of situation here. Zachary Fitzwater would lose control. The 25 of Nakula and the 2 of Charles Sanford would get collected. Everyone would continue, though. Scott Roush leads on the restart, and one of the big concerns we're getting to now is that this race could end on a time limit thing here. You got to get to lap 260 by 2 hours, or else the 2-hour time limit kicks in for all 130, for all races, normal races, there is a 2-hour time limit. Oh, Roush has to pit now, and that's going to put Roush's hopes are dampened, and that's going to give the lead back to Jacob Hart, who is back out there with the lead. There's Dodd. Dodd was another driver who was up running pretty good for a while there, as Jacob Hart just took the lead. The next caution of the race would happen when Juan Pablo Corona would get onto the apron here and lose the rear end of his car, trying to get to pit road. Ryan Matthews would slide in. Meanwhile, Nick Pericles would blow up the one car and fall out of the race as well, so tough break for Pericles. Eddie Shimpadkar would have some issues on pit road here as he's trying to leave the pits, and, well, Skylar Johnson puts him into the back end of the 20 car and into the back end of the 61. So Kyle Bischelia will lead over Scott Roush, Jacob Hart, who pitted, and Kyle Collins, who also pitted, so these four cars are the four left in this race. And like I said, we have a 2-hour time limit that we have to abide by. So we're about 7 minutes behind where we're supposed to be. Now, if we get a green flag run, we might see all 260 laps go in. But I am a little bit skeptical of that, to be honest with you. However, we would get another caution here for some rather silliness going on here. A bunch of cars were trying to pit, and Paulson slowed up and brought out a yellow, and Bazianov gets into the wall. So the other two cars that were in the lead group have now made their pit stops, giving Jacob Hart the lead, but now there's a bunch of cars trying to get back onto the lead lap. green flag is out once again here at Louisiana. And hopefully this time we can get a little bit of green flag running. And we had a nice 40 lap green flag start. And well, not seem like we're going to get that again at this rate. I think we are going to hit the 2 hour limit on this race. Kind of surprising to see that they're... We've seen it before this 2 hour limit was instituted, where we've gotten close to it, but I don't know if we've ever hit it. Alex Allen hits again. Kyle Collins is now being held up by Zachary Fitzwater as Collins is trying to reel in the 47 car in front of him. The 3 car is pretty quick today and is probably the cleanest car out there right now, except Jacob Hart, who I think... Does Jacob Hart not have a scratch on that car? That's kind of surprising. Third place is Kyle Bischelia. Kind of surprising to see him up there that high. But right now, Jacob Hart leads. Damir Bazianov is really holding up some of these cars like Moshe Gurian, Scott Roush, Sean Angel, and a couple other cars here. They're all trying to get by Bazianov, who has been very slow today. There's Ryan Matthews, who was on the lead lap, but has heavy rear end damage right now. Right now, Chris Dodds hoping for a yellow because he is about to be lapped here by Jacob Hart. And Dodds right now would be on the lead lap if a caution came out. Likewise would be Charles Sanford and Tristan Wilhoit. They would be on the lead lap as well. As, they're going to be hoping for a yellow here as Hart now is all over the back of Dodd. With Scott Roush running P4, this could be another increase to his point lead today. We didn't expect this out of Roush because Roush barely qualified for the race, but we're seeing Scott Roush doing very well here. He's got a pretty big point lead and is doing quite well. However, Kyle Collins would eventually get underneath Jacob Hart with help from the two Minervinis and take the lead from him. A little bit of contact there between Fitzwater and Hart. So Kyle Collins is now your leader of this race. Oh, Bazianov's being very nasty there with Jacob Hart, or with Collins there. So it looks like Dodd's coming on pit road. Maybe some tire issues for Dodd. But yeah, Kyle Collins leads this race. And Kyle Bischelia now is going to try and catch Hart and Collins. Up until the point where Wilhoit and Samper have caught this pack, they have been the fastest two cars on the track, ironically. So now that they're caught in the pack, it's going to be very difficult for them to start making moves, to be honest with you. However, with help from the 48, or from help from the 90 car, Jacob Hart would retake the lead over Kyle Collins now. As now we're getting a bit of a green flag run, knock on wood. Hopefully we can keep it for a little while here. And at this rate, we would probably see the end of this race. We're under 100 to go. Actually, under 80 to go. Dodd is not going to play too friendly there with Jacob Hart. And Kyle Collins now is going to try and catch Hart again. Problem is that all these cars are needing to pass on the inside, passing these lap cars who are taking the outside. And, well, the inside is not the easiest line to get around, to be honest. Kyle Collins has been caught in some heavy lap traffic, and that's going to make it a nice run there by Jacob Hart to get away from Collins because of it. Oh, we got a crash there, but did they bring out the yellow for that? No, we're staying green. That was Bischelia and Gurry in there getting a big hit there. However, Arxo would bring out the yellow for this. So I guess Kyle Bischelia losing control of the car would bring out the yellow. It's kind of stupid if you ask me. So Jacob Hart will lead on the restart. As you can see, Bischelia, because of that, is on the tail end of the lead lap. He had to pit for an extended period of time there. And here we go again. And now you're actually seeing Wilhoit and Sanford being on the lead lap. Now as Roush is just hanging on for dear life. As there is Jacob Hart leading this race once again. However, Alex Allen would spin out and lose control, and that's going to bring out another caution right there on lap 217, and a lot of rear end and front end damage to Charles Sanford despite leading this race. Or not being in second, rather. The other big name is that Tristan Wilhoit would fall out of the race due to a mechanical problem. on that caution. So green flag is coming back out with 20, with about under 18 minutes to go, but under only a handful of laps to go now. As Collins has some rear end damage from pit road contact. There's a lot of pit road contact under that last caution, but Jacob Hart, who's dominated this race, is still doing quite well, but now Alex Allen's got to pretty much let his teammate go by, and Allen's just out there, I think, just to snack up points, so he's not going to be in the qualifier beyond Talladega if he does well at Dega. Over a debris caution would fly the next time, or on lap 238, bringing out the caution again. This time I think it was actually, maybe it wasn't debris. Well, it was something off of Sanford's car, I think. We checked, everywhere there wasn't any wrecking, so no caution, or no thing there for no on-track incident. So with 18 minutes to go, the green flag would fly once again now, and this is big because now Kyle Collins has cleared some of the lap traffic this caution. And now, there's Charles Sanford and Gurrien now are struggling. So now it's up to Collins to catch, maybe. We had a car maybe get to the wall there, but Gurrien missed the pit road. But now it's all Collins' job now to try and catch Jacob Hart. Only 11 minutes to go here in this race, and there's 15 laps to go, but luckily this is a pretty quick track. I think if we get another caution, though, we might not see the finish of this race come by, and it might be a timed event. But we're seeing it now. It's coming down to the wire for some of these drivers here. Oh, there's Sanford wrecking it, and Sanford is going to bring out a yellow, and that's going to make this race very close on time. Jacob Hart would lead on the restart with only 8 laps to go, with Kyle Collins right behind him. There is about 7.5 minutes to go. If this race goes green the rest of the way, which it should, I think it's either going to be a caution now and the race is over, or it'll go green the rest of the way. Because if there's a caution, even if there is enough laps, they won't have the time to finish the race. There's Sanford coming out of the pits once again. Collins' teammate. And that's going to be something very difficult for some of these drivers to really maintain what they're doing. Sanford's going to wreck it again. No caution so far. They're going to keep it green. Going to keep it green. Not long left in this race, and Collins has really got to close in. We're on board with Kyle Collins now as he's trying to reel in Jacob Hart, the dominant car of the day. However, the handling really does suck on the two car, and he would lose control of it again, and that's going to bring out the caution. So it's a race back to the line now. There's not going to be enough laps left in this race to get back to the green, and Jacob Hart's going to pretty much win this race. So under the final lap now, under yellow, Jacob Hart leads over Kyle Collins, and Scott Roush gets on the podium. Fourth position is going to go to Kyle Buscellia. Fifth to Mattias Paulsen. Sixth is going to go to Sean Angel. Seventh to Michaels. Eighth goes to Johnson. Ninth is Ryan Matthews. And the final car in the top 10 is Alex Allen, as Jacob Hart wins at the grand speed of 35 miles an hour. Hart wins. Great showing by Jacob Hart. He was dominant all day. Jacob Hart wins the race here in Louisiana. So, Jacob Hart wins the race. Kyle Collins second, Scott Roush third, Buscellia fourth, Paulsen fifth, Angel sixth, Johnson seventh, Matthews eighth, Alex Allen ninth, Ryan Matthews ninth, I'm sorry, tenth, Alex Allen 11th, DJ Curtis 12th, Jessica Shelton 13th, to Charles Sanford 11 laps down, and then everybody else didn't finish the race. 14th to Gurrien, 15th to Washer, 16th to Will Hoyt, 17th to Fitzwater, 18th to Dodd, 19th to Arndt, 20th to Corona, 21st to Bazianov, who was almost made the finish, but he was so many laps down that he didn't even make it that far. 22nd to Chupadkar, 23rd to Pericles, 24th to Nikula, 25th to Fingai, 26th to Matty Maia, 27th to Ray Hall, 28th to Ethan Moore, 29th to Ben Atkins, 30th to Vincent Allen, 31st to Griffin, 32nd to Ekdahl, 33rd to Perkins, 34th to DeMax, 35th to Noah Hart, the pole sitter, 36th to Vanderpesch, 37th to Shepard, 38th to Saber, 39th to Baskinger, and 40th to Brock. The next race is the last race that only the top 25 in driver points from last year will make the race. And after this race, we flip over to the top 35 in driver's points this season making the race. That's going to be very interesting as we go to Talladega. Anyway, we'll see you for the round of Alabama at Talladega, the final American race in the first little American stint.